Okay, first and foremost, I want to give all honors and praises and glory belongs to my Lord and Savior, Yahweh Baisham, Yahavashai, Bahasham, Wahavaka Kodash. And honors to the elder apostles that taught me this truth, and those of you that are in the Holy Spirit, and to the hopeful elect across the globe, and to the few, very few, brothers and sisters that are listening and learning in the hopes of being saved in these last days. Okay, and before I start this lesson, I have to throw this out there, because there's a lot of demons out there. There's a lot of demons, even within this truth. The reason why, when I'm outside, when I'm doing the lessons on the highways and byways, I need to shout, because there's cars going past, and the scripture says, "Lift up thy voice like a trumpet." But when a man is doing a sit down, he ain't going to be shouting. He's still going to be in the same spirit, but he's not going to be shouting. And I have to put that out there, because you've got wicked demons of our own nation that will say, oh, you know, he's got an alter ego. He's got a split personality. No. When you're off the highways and byways, it's like, you're mellow. You're doing a sit down, so I'm not going to be shouting. And this is why Yahweh is just going to destroy a lot of men. Okay, and the same men that will say that, guess what, they're amongst bug outs. They don't even have any discernment. So let's continue, let's go to Ephesians 5, right, and 14. That's why you only got to be concerned with what Yahweh Shai thinks, because men can switch up any given time. It's Ephesians 5 and 14. Wherefore he saith, awake thou that sleepest, and arise from the dead, and Mashiach shall give thee light. So, to be awake, that means to be alive. What makes us alive? These words, the Spirit, the Holy Spirit, makes us alive. Okay? When you go to Ezekiel 37, it talks about what the valley of the dry bones, those that were stood up on their feet. It is through what? The word, and arise from the dead, because we're no longer in a dead state. Okay? The two-thirds of the wicked of our people, they're still in a zombified, dead state. And what's the only thing that can wake them up? This truth, through Yahweh Shrine, and Mashiach shall give you the light. Verse 15, see then that you walk circumspectly. And when you go into that word circumspectly, it means full circle, means full circle, 360 degrees, full circle. And spectly with your eyes, so you've got to be looking at it, especially in these times. This is the most evil time. This is the most evil generation. So we were told to walk circumspectly. Look around. Observe your surroundings. What's going on? Because there's always something that's going on in the street. There's always someone that's plotting. There's always someone that's scheming. Okay? Not as fools, but as wise, because a fool would say, are you sure it ain't just you? Well, the scriptures are saying, walk as what, circumspectly, not as fools. A fool would say, well, no, you know, how do you know wickedness is, because it's all around us. So knowing that all this wickedness is around us, what, we have to walk circumspectly, not as fools, because the world is walking around as fools. And the scriptures say in Matthew's, what, 25, I think it's 25 chapter, about the five wise virgins and the five foolish virgins. The foolish virgins, they never had the oil in their lamps, so they were running what? They were mad at the virgins that had what, the five, so like the five wise virgins that had the oil. So it's the same thing in this truth today. So those that weren't really taking the truth seriously, they're going to be running to those with the oil. This is why you've got to take this seriously. Okay? But as wise, the wise man's going to apply these words. And who shall I liken unto a wise man? Him that built his house upon a rock, a sure foundation. Redeem in the time, because the days are evil. Bear me just a minute. When you're redeeming the time, what are you doing? To redeem is what you're regaining something by possession. And how do you do that? It's related to wisdom. So the time you're spending is what, in wisdom, through these prophecies, okay? Because the days are evil. So the scripts are even telling you, this is an evil time. This is the most evilest time. Scriptures warn us of these things. Wherefore, be not unwise for understanding what the word of the Lord is. And what's the word of the Lord, Yahweh Yahushua? For him to destroy the wicked, okay, and deliver his elect, okay? And be not drunk with wine wherein excess. If you're drinking too much, you're not going to be able to think properly. Your mind ain't going to process properly. But you can drink, but this is more so also speaking of the philosophies. Okay? Stick to the scriptures. Don't get into none of these other books. The book of Jephthah, the book of, what's it, the book of Enoch, the book of the dead. Stick with the scriptures, but be filled with the Spirit. So we want to be filled as much as possible. Because that's what's going to guide us. That's what's going to protect us. And speaking to yourself in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, singing and making melody in your heart to the Lord Yahweh Yahushua. Okay? And that goes with what prayer. Even when you're doing these lessons, it's a melody. Okay? Goes up, goes down. So even when the individual says that, or he's happy one day, he's sad the next day, bro, Yahushua had these same emotions, but he kept it in check. The prophets had the same emotions, so a lot of men are not reading of Yahushua. And the same men that would say that, most of the time, they're depressed. You know? They do reprobate videos. I hope we make it. Yeah, of course we hope we make it. But what type of spirit do you have towards Yahushua? Are you following the multitude to do evil? Are you following Yahushua? Nothing but zombies. That's all I see is dead people everywhere. Thank you, Yahweh Yahushua, for the sermon. If you have the sermon, thank you, Yahweh Yahushua, for that. Let's go to Ezekiel 33 and 30. And the main premise of this lesson as well, the latest things that Esau's doing. He's got a new strain of the virus. I forgot what it's called. He's got a so-called new strain of this virus. And by tomorrow, this is what Tuesday, by tomorrow, if anybody doesn't have a mask on their face when they're in what public transport and the supermarkets, they will be fined. And this legislation is coming in through what, tomorrow? Okay? So all these things are happening. Right? And another thing as well, I don't know if you brothers have been sent any messages on the YouTube channels. There was also a message from, I got this message a couple of days ago, but it says from what, I think it's the 5th of January. There's going to be new things done, new measures with the YouTube. They're going to be bringing in new measures. Okay? On YouTube, new downs, new restrictions. Okay? So all these things are being put into play. And you know what? It makes sense. Because what have you had this year? The beginning of this year, you had the G20 meetings. And what's it, the COP20 meeting, if I'm saying it right as well? The COP21 meeting, if I'm pronouncing it right. So all of these things, what, to pass legislation to get particular things in order. One in the last days. If you're not serious now, you're not going to be serious. If you're not serious now, let's go to Ezekiel 33 and 30. This is not a joke. This is life and death. Isaiah 33 and 30. Also, thou son of man, the children of thy people still are talking against thee by the walls. So you've got a people that watch the videos, but they don't put any action in. They don't put no action in. They don't do nothing for Yahushua to show how much they care, to show how much they want salvation. So you've got people watching the videos behind closed doors with popcorn in their hands or chicken or whatever they're eating or some ice cream, thinking this is entertainment. Oh, they're going to get caught out. And in the doors of thy houses, and speak one to another, every one with his brother, to his brother. And a brother could be friend, a neighbor of your own nation. Saying, come, I pray you, and hear what is the word that cometh from the Lord Yahweh Yahushua. So you've got those that say, you know what, we're going to visit. You know, we're going to visit, see what he has to say. But it's not with the right intentions. Okay? And you've had individuals, people like that, You don't waste your time with people like that. They've heard this word, you've been watching for a little while now, and I've told this one individual, I'm not even gonna put his name. I am gonna put your name out there. This Greg, what's your name? Greg Nawasu. I don't know if I'm saying it right. Greg Nawasu. You've been watching for some time, and if you're watching this, you have to get out. And I told you already. I told you about a year ago, or even longer than that. Bro, if you have the means to teach, get out there. You've been watching. Okay, this is not a joke. And hear the words, but they will not do them. It's lucky, and they come in just a minute. And they come unto thee as thy people cometh. And Greg Nawasu, you came up to the camp several times from Oxford Street and from the other place we were at as well, from Havelock. I think it was, what, Havelock? Havelock House or something like that. Okay, and the next street we were in with the other camp, you were there. Okay, so you've obviously been watching, so what's stopping you from doing the work? So do it. Okay, if it's in you to do it, go out, push these lessons. Nobody's going to hold your hand, this is not a joke. And they come unto thee as thy people cometh, and they sit before thee as my people, and they hear thy words, but they will not do them. So, again, you have our people, they will hear these words, they say, yeah, Kong Kong, but they will not do them, they will not apply them. The Lord's looking for those that are actually going to do. And we know we're going to have a lot of people that have not done any of the works and they're going to be saved. But if it's in you, and if, especially if Yahushua has given you signs, look, I need to do something. Because that's what got me teaching. The scripture says, woe unto me if I preach not the gospel. I never forget Elder Apostle done a video about woe unto me if I don't preach this gospel. And I thought, you know what? I can't sit on this truth. That's what we're bugging you at. You sitting on this truth and not doing anything about it. This is heavy level information, knowledge. How can you just sit on it, keep it in your dome without doing anything? You have to teach this word. You have to do something for the ministry, for Yahweh Shai. But they will not do them, for with their mouth they show much love. Yeah, I hear you. I hear what you're saying. You know, brilliant video, good video. I was edified. But what are you doing? It's all well and nice you saying that, but what are you doing to further yourself to make sure you can be saved also? You know it's answered, what predestination, but what are you doing? For with their mouth they show much love. I love you, Hamasha. Do something then. But their heart go after their covetous, it goes after the things of this world. Alright? And now the art unto them, a very lovely song of one that have a pleasant voice. Okay? So this just sounds good to them. Why? Because this is a song. Also, this is a song that we're singing. And can play well on an instrument. So certain people listen because they just like the way a certain brother may speak, the way he brings up the scriptures. Bro, if you're thinking like that, Baba Kasha, repent. Okay? But they hear the words, but they will not, but they're not doing them. But they hear it. So that means you're held responsible now because you've heard the word. And when this cometh to pass, though it will come, then shall they know that a prophet has been among them. So in that time, when all hell breaks loose, hear them and know. He was speaking the truth. Ray was speaking the truth. You've got to realize that. Go to Amos 8 and 11. All these restrictions are being put in. Amos 8 and 11, behold the days come, saith the Lord, you have thy power, that I will send a famine in the land. Not a famine of bread, not a thirst for water, right? Which that is going to be, okay? But this is zoning in another particular famine, but a hearing of the words of the Lord, you have a shine. That's what there's going to be a famine of. That's what there's going to be a shortage of. The hearing of these words. Okay? Because the men of the Lord, we're not going to be easily accessible. Right now you can still log in and watch these videos, but there's going to be a time when that's not going to be accessible, right? Everything's going to be taken down, everything's going to be renewed. Remember Esau, he's doing what? A reset, a new system. But you can't even go onto these platforms unless you're tuned into the system. This helps them. So why you have the time now, get this word. Don't mess about. One verse over, they shall wander from sea to sea, from the north, even to the east. They shall run to and from to seek the word of the Lord and shall not find it. That's going to be what? The punishment for those that were just taking this for a joke. Okay? That's why you want to take the truth seriously. So on to the next one. Shalom.